Good morning students. In this class we are going to derive an expression which relates equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressure and equilibrium constant in terms of active mass. Let us consider a general equilibrium reaction. X A plus Y B equilibrium L C plus M D, where A and B are reactants, C and D are products. Here all the reactants and products are ideal gases. X is the stoichiometric coefficient of reactant A. Y is the stoichiometric coefficient of reactant B. L is the stoichiometric coefficient of product C. M is the stoichiometric coefficient of product D. For this reaction, we can write equilibrium constant in terms of active mass as well as partial pressure. First, equilibrium constant in terms of active mass. Kc is equal to active mass of product C with stoichiometric coefficient L into active mass of product D with stoichiometric coefficient M divided by active mass of reactant A with stoichiometric coefficient X into active mass of reactant B with stoichiometric coefficient Y. This is equation number 1. Then equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressure. Kp is equal to partial pressure of product C with stoichiometric coefficient L into partial pressure of product D with stoichiometric coefficient M divided by partial pressure of reactant A with stoichiometric coefficient X into partial pressure of reactant B with stoichiometric coefficient Y. This is equation number 2. We know that ideal gas equation is PV is equal to nRT. we know that ideal gas equation is PV is equal to nRT. This is equation number 3. Rearranging this equation, pressure is equal to N divided by V into RT. Therefore, pressure P is equal to active mass into RT, since N by V is equal to active mass. This is equation number 4. By using this expression, we can write partial pressure terms of reactants and products. By using this expression, we can write partial pressure terms of reactants and products. Partial pressure of reactant A with stoichiometric coefficient X is equal to active mass of reactant A with stoichiometric coefficient X into RT whole to the power X. Then partial pressure of reactant B with the stoichiometric coefficient Y is equal to active mass of reactant B with the stoichiometric coefficient Y into RT whole to the power Y. Then partial pressure of product C with stoichiometric coefficient L is equal to active mass of product C with stoichiometric coefficient L into RT whole to the power L. Then partial pressure of product D with stoichiometric coefficient M is equal to active mass of product D with stoichiometric coefficient M into RT whole to the power M. This is equation number 5. Using equation number 5, in equation number 2, Kp is equal to partial pressure of product C with stoichiometric coefficient L is replaced by this term, that is active mass of C with stoichiometric coefficient L into RT whole to the power L into partial pressure of product D with stoichiometric coefficient M is replaced by this term, that is active mass of product D with stoichiometric coefficient M into RT whole to the power M divided by partial pressure of reactant A with stoichiometric coefficient X is replaced by this term, that is active mass of A with stoichiometric coefficient X into RT whole to the power X into partial pressure of reactant B with stoichiometric coefficient Y is replaced by this term, that is active mass of reactant B with stoichiometric coefficient Y into RT whole to the power Y. This is equation number 6. Rearranging this equation, Kp is equal to active mass of product C with the stoichiometric coefficient L into active mass of product D with the stoichiometric coefficient M into RT whole to the power L into RT whole to the power M divided by active mass of reactant A with stoichiometric coefficient X into active mass of reactant B with stoichiometric coefficient Y into RT whole to the power X into RT whole to the power Y. Active mass of C with stoichiometric coefficient L into active mass of D with stoichiometric coefficient M into RT whole to the power L plus M divided by active mass of A with stoichiometric coefficient X into active mass of B with the stoichiometric coefficient Y into RT whole to the power X plus Y. Since P power X dot P power Y is equal to P power X plus Y, then Kp is equal to active mass of C with stoichiometric coefficient L into active mass of D stoichiometric coefficient M. Then Kp is equal to active mass of C with stoichiometric coefficient L into active mass of D with stoichiometric coefficient M into Rt whole to the power L plus M into Rt whole to the power minus of X plus Y divided by active mass of A stoichiometric coefficient X into active mass of B the stoichiometric coefficient Y, since 1 by P power X plus Y is equal to P power minus of X plus Y. Then active mass of C with stoichiometric coefficient L into active mass of D with stoichiometric coefficient M into Rt whole to the power L plus M minus X plus Y divided by active mass of A with stoichiometric coefficient X into active mass of B with stoichiometric coefficient Y, since P power X dot P power minus Y is equal to P power X minus Y. P power X dot P power minus Y is equal to P power X minus Y. Then active mass of C with stoichiometric coefficient L, active mass of D with stoichiometric coefficient M divided by active mass of A with the stoichiometric coefficient X into active mass of B with the stoichiometric coefficient Y is replaced by equilibrium constant in terms of active mass, that is Kc into Rt whole to the power L plus M minus of X plus Y is replaced by delta N G. Is equal to Kp. That is Kp is equal to Kc into Rt whole to the power delta N G. Since active mass of C with stoichiometric coefficient L into active mass of D with the stoichiometric coefficient M divided by active mass of A with the stoichiometric coefficient X into active mass of B with the stoichiometric coefficient Y is equal to Kc, and L plus M minus of X plus Y is equal to delta N G. L plus M minus of X plus Y is equal to delta N G. This is equation number 7. This equation number 7 gives a relation between equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressure and equilibrium constant in terms of active mass. In this equation, delta Ng is the difference between the sum of number of moles of products and the sum of number of moles of the reactants in gas phase. Then case 1, when delta Ng is equal to 0, Kp is equal to Kc. When delta Ng is equal to 0, then Kp is equal to Kc. Example, let us consider hydrogen iodide formation, H2 gas plus I2 gas, equilibrium. Hydrogen iodide gas. Hydrogen reacts with iodine to give hydrogen iodide. We know that delta Ng is equal to NpG minus NrG. This is equation number 1. For this reaction, NpG is equal to 2, since NpG is nothing but sum of number of moles of gaseous product minus, for this reaction, NrG is equal to 2, since NrG is nothing but sum of number of moles of gaseous reactants. Here, number of moles of hydrogen is equal to 1. Here also, number of moles of gaseous iodine is equal to 1. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. Therefore, 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. We know that Kp is equal to Kc into RT whole to the power delta Ng. This is equation number 3. Using delta Ng value in equation number 3 or using equation number 2 in equation number 3, Kp is equal to Kc into RT whole to the power 0. Kc into 1, since constant to the power 0 is equal to 1. Here, R is a constant, T is also a constant, their product gives another one constant. So, constant to the power 0 is replaced by 1. Therefore, Kp is equal to Kc. then case 2. When delta mg is equal to positive, then Kp is greater than Kc. When delta mg is equal to positive, then Kp is greater than Kc. Example, decomposition of ammonia, NH3 gas equilibrium, N2 gas plus hydrogen gas. We know that delta Mg is equal to NpG minus NrG. This is equation number 1. For this reaction, NpG is 4. Since number of moles of N2 is 1 and number of moles of hydrogen is 3. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. NpG is replaced by 4 minus, for this reaction, NrG is 2. Since number of moles of ammonia molecule is 2, 4 minus 2 is equal to 2, that is plus 2. Delta Mg value for this reaction is equal to plus 2. This is equation number 3. We know that Kp is equal to Kc into Rt whole to the power delta Mg. This is equation number 2. This is equation number 3. Using equation number 2 in equation number 3, Kp is equal to Kc into Rt whole to the power delta Mg. Delta Mg value for this reaction is 2, that is plus 2. Therefore, Kp is greater than Kc. Then case 3. When delta Mg is negative, then Kp is less than Kc. When delta Mg is negative, Kp is less than Kc. Example, sulfur trioxide formation, SO2 gas plus O2 gas equilibrium SO3 gas. We know that delta Mg is equal to NpG minus NrG. This is equation number 1. For this reaction, NpG is 2 minus, for this reaction, NrG is 3. Since number of moles of SO2 gas is 2 and number of moles of O2 gas is 1. 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. 2 minus 3 is equal to minus 1. Therefore, delta Ng for this reaction is equal to minus 1. This is equation number 2. We know that Kp is equal to Kc into RT whole to the power delta Ng. This is equation number 3. Using equation number 2 in equation number 3, Kp is equal to Kc into RT whole to the power delta Ng is replaced by minus 1. Kc divided by RT. Kp, rearranging this equation, Kp into RT is equal to Kc. Therefore, Kp is lesser than Kc.
சார் எத்தனை நிமிஷம் வந்திருக்கு சார்?